Do you have the habit of rocking a chair? Then you probably would have tipped over or almost lost your balance sometimes. Center of gravity is the culprit in this scenario. In this video, we will learn about the center of gravity and some architectural wonders and activities that utilize the science behind this concept. Before looking into the center of gravity, we have to understand what is centroid. Centroid is the geometric center of planar or two-dimensional shapes. Let's look at some examples. First, let's take a circle. Anybody can easily tell that the geometric center of the circle is the point which is equidistant from each point on the circle. Now let's take a square. The point where the diagonals of the square intersect each other is the centroid of the square. In case of the triangle, the centroid is the point of intersection of its medians. In the same way, we can find the geometric center or centroid of many complex two-dimensional geometric shapes. Now let's move into three-dimensional bodies. In a symmetrically shaped body made of homogeneous material, the geometric center is where the center of gravity lies. To be precise, the center of gravity is an imaginary point of a body of matter where the total weight of the body is thought to be concentrated. Gravitational force acting along the center of gravity pulls objects toward the center of the Earth. Finding the location of the center of gravity plays a crucial role in engineering and design because it predicts the behavior of a moving body when acted upon by gravity. Construction of buildings, bridges, designing of cars, airplanes are the few applications. In car racing, the designer's foremost priority is to create maximum downward force. It is essential in achieving the highest cornering speeds. When cars take a turn at very high speeds along the curved path, centrifugal force may exceed the traction force between ground and the tires. This leads to the toppling of the vehicle. If the center of gravity stays higher and the line of action of force falls outside the base of the vehicle. To prevent this, the center of gravity of the race cars is maintained close to the ground surface as much as possible. In addition to that, aerodynamic design also creates enough downward force to keep the car close to the surface at high speeds. The center of gravity is the reason why the Pisa Tower is indestructible. Construction of the Pisa Tower began in the 12th century and completed in 14th century. While constructing the second floor, the tower started to lean. Major reason for the leaning is the mere 3-meter depth foundation set in weak and unstable subsoil. This fault made the tower one of the wonders in the world. So how does the tower remain in its tilted position and doesn't tip over? According to the calculations, the 14,500 metric ton tower's center of gravity is lying on the fourth floor. Amazingly, the line of action of gravitational force remained within the base of the building throughout centuries. And renovation done from time to time also ensured the same. By 1990, the tilt angle reached the maximum value of 5.5 degrees. After a decade-long strengthening work, the problem was fixed and the tilt angle was reduced to 4 degrees. Wind velocity, earthquakes, waves are the major factors to be considered while constructing skyscrapers. Now let's look at the world's tallest building, Burj Khalifa, which measures 829.8 meters. Burj Khalifa has a wider base compared to its top. Designers gradually reduced its cross-sectional area proportional to its altitude. As a result of this, its center of gravity stays lower. It's an engineering marvel. Learning from past mistakes, engineering and engineers have evolved over centuries. Finally, tightrope walking. Tightrope walking, also known as funambulism, is an art of walking on a tightrope. All over the world, trained people walk on tightropes tied between various skyscrapers to gain recognition. While walking on slippery surfaces is termed risky, walking on a tightrope tied several feet above the ground is definitely not a child's play. So how do these artists balance themselves on a thin rope? Again, the center of gravity. While walking on a thin rope, the artisans carry a stick for balance. This stick helps to make sure the center of gravity of the person lies on the rope. When the person sways, they adjust the stick, thereby balancing the center of gravity. Thank you for traveling with us. For more such infotainment videos, visit our channel Black Story.